Who put in the rec for 6-year exam at Night Raven College students in the first place? It was an anonymous tip via the Land of Dawning government channels, and it was totally untraceable. That's omega sus. Overbots are talked about as if they're incredibly rare circumstances, but since September, Night Raven College has had a total of 5 overbots and 1 blot-related rampage. It was already a head-scratcher, but with the details given by Idia, the case deepens and it becomes much more of a juicy mystery. Today, let's try and figure out who the whistleblower was and what their motive could have been. Let's start off with the basics. What do we know for sure? We know that the whistleblower was anonymous and made it so that no one would know who submitted the tip. They clearly did not want the tip to be linked back to them. Next, we know the initial request was actually sent to the government of the Land of Dawning, who then contacted Styx. Styx was not contacted directly by the tipster. Whether or not the tipster was trying for Styx and had to go through the government to get to them is unknown. It's equally likely that the tipster just wanted the government to look into it and didn't think Styx would get involved. Before we move on to suspects, I want to point out something that applies to almost all the suspects. Although we as players know there's been 5 overblots, the school is only aware of 4. Riddle, Leona, Azul, and Jameel. Vils was only witnessed by NRC Tribe, and none of them spoke up about it as far as we know. In addition to the overblots, there's 1 blot-induced rampage that no one really knows about except for Adusu, Dire, and then the House Wardens. It's still a lot, but I just want to point out the actual number of overblots and blot-related rampages is higher than what most people at NRC know. And now that that's out of the way, let's talk about our suspects. It's always possible we haven't met the actual culprit. Who knows? Maybe it's someone we have yet to meet. But if we only take into account characters we know, these are the most likely suspects to me. I'll be fully transparent. Normally, I try not to go too hard in one direction. I want my viewers to weigh the information I give them and others comment and come to their own conclusion. But I have to admit, I think I know who did it, and I only really believe one person could have done it. I'll obviously give everyone a fair chance still, but I just want to be transparent. Our first suspect is Divas Cruel. His possible motive? There's a lot of overblots happening, and a blot specialist might be needed to prevent future overblots. Cruel clearly cares about his students, and it wouldn't surprise me if he turned to someone else to get his students the help they truly need. Cause like, the school counselors aren't doing shit. Let's be real here, they're not doing anything. However, for every possible reason, it feels like there's another reason that he would not. For starters, why speak up now? As far as Cruel is aware, the last overblot happened a while ago. Why wait until now to say something? If he wanted to submit something, wouldn't he have done it after Azul or Jameel's overblot? I also don't think Zivas would need to be an anonymous tipster. He has slash had a flourishing fashion design career. While it's probably not a stable income as teaching, although teachers are not paid enough and that's a whole other discussion for another day, he's clearly doing well enough, and even if he lost his job because of whistleblowing, it's not like he has absolutely nothing to fall back on. There's some lines that imply that he's still active in the fashion world. Not to mention, I don't think he would care if Dire knew it was him. Ultimately, I don't think it was Divas. Our second suspect is Moses Train. Possible motive? Like Cruel, he genuinely cares about the students and doesn't hesitate to help protect them. Clearly, what the school is doing isn't helping prevent overblots, so someone on the outside needs to be contacted. And unlike Cruel, he doesn't have a second career going on, he just has teaching. And obviously, he could find another teaching job, but this would be a riskier move for him, and he might be justified in being anonymous. Dire is a vindictive man, after all, and I'm sure Train is well aware of that. You can't tell me Dire's passive-aggressive remarks go over his head. But on the other hand, Train is well aware of who Styx is. And being aware of them, he surely knows that to the public, no one ever returns from the Isle of Woe, or Lamentation, I don't remember how they localized it. Despite wanting the best for his students, I can't see him doing something that would involve so many students being taken there. It's possible he didn't know the abductions would happen, but I personally can't see him taking any sort of risk like that. So, who's left that could have done it? I personally don't think it was anyone inside NRC. In my opinion, it makes the most sense if it was an outsider. And with all these weird circumstances, I'm convinced our culprit is Ambrose the 63rd, head mage of the Royal Sword Academy. To start off, he doesn't know about the overblot. How could he know? But after Vil's overblot, he has this very strange exchange with Crowley. He clearly knows something has happened. Crowley probably looks like he was trying to cover it up, although we know he didn't actually know, or he just didn't care. And this could be why Ambrose tipped off the government. This would also explain why the tip was sent in when it was. How could he have sent a tip in for previous overblots when he didn't know about them? But this just happened, and the tip was presumably sent around this time. If Ambrose was the one who contacted the government, it also makes sense why the tip was untraceable. If Ambrose accused Nightraven College of covering up Overwatch and it turned out to be false, that would do irreparable damage to not just his reputation, but to Royal Sword Academy's. Overblots are serious, and to accuse a cover-up like that is a giant accusation. So being anonymous while tipping off on it would be necessary to protect his and his school's reputation. But why? Why would Ambrose make the tip in the first place? It's true he doesn't have any reason to care about the NRC students, but an overblot poses a risk to everyone on Sage's Island. If it got out of hand, it would become everyone's problem real fast. I wrote this before Chapter 7 came out and only came back to it recently. And given what's happened in Chapter 7, it turns out this is true. We have an overblot that's affecting everyone on the island. But anyways, from his exchange with Crowley, it doesn't seem like he has a lot of faith in Dire to control his students or keep things safe. Huge fair. He's not wrong. Ambrose might feel like he needs to step in, or maybe he just wants to knock NRC down a peg. I don't know, school rivalries are like, freaking weird. I never understood them when I was in high school and I still don't get them. But I think out of everyone who we know could have done it, Ambrose makes the most sense to me. But who do you guys think did it? Do you also think Ambrose did it? Or someone from NRC? Or someone we haven't even met yet? Let me know! Thank you everyone for watching, and a very special thank you to my channel members and Twitch subs. Your support helps me to continue to make these videos. If you'd like early access to my videos, consider becoming a channel member. Patrons and Ko-fi members can get my scripts early before I record them. I livestream over on Twitch every Tuesday, Thursday, and Sunday. Thanks again, guys, and I'll see y'all later.